that were being planted, pitting the poor against the rich, the young against the old, one faith against the other, tribe against tribe. We warned that the country needed to embrace a tradition of making compromises for the sake of the nation. We warned that leaders need to unclench their fists and shaking hands for the sake of the nation, and we call for the cleansing of the land of the spirit of anger and bitterness, the spirit of revenge and entitlement, and to continue on a path that reconciles, unites, calms, and stabilizes the nation. Above all, we warn that mere words and catchy slogans alone would not work. We told our people to study history and see where it had led those countries that fell victims to the sweet tongues of politicians who were selling snake oil to desperate populations. We also warned them of the theory of Mr. Goebbels during Adolf Hitler's period. An angry and bitter duo of Ruto and Gachagua, who served the will of the people, have now taken the low road and are summoning the worst demons to drive our nation into a ditch. It is clear the class war that Ruto promised during the campaigns is being actualized. This is how collapse begins. It is unfortunate that Ruto is so scared of losing legitimate power that it will damage the environment and the economy just to stay in office. But Ruto must make no mistake. I repeat, Ruto must make no mistake. This struggle will march on, stronger and mightier, with his every vile response until our demands are met. One, the cost of goods must come down. Two, servers must be opened. Three, the reconstitution of IBC must be above board and consultative and bipartisan. And that reconstitution must also mean restructuring of the IBC. We have won against Ruto and his violence before. We shall win against Ruto and his violence again. End of statement. Tumesema kwa Kiswahili.